This is the FM Gold Channel of All India Radio. In the program News Analysis, now we bring you a discussion on significance of Prime Minister's visit to Maldives. The participants are Ashok Sajjanhar, former diplomat, and Ninova Roy Chaudhary, journalist.
Prime Minister Narendra Modi arrived in Malé in the Maldives to attend the swearing in ceremony of the president-elect Ibrahim Soli. For India, this has been a major achievement in the coming, in the sense that relations with the final sort of area in the neighborhood seem to be really coming good. Ambassador Ashok Sajjanhar, would you please explain to us why this particular inauguration ceremony at this juncture is so important and why the Prime Minister felt it necessary to go to Malé at this point of time?
Prime Minister termed this victory by the Maldives Democratic Party as historic. And he was the first foreign leader to have called Ibrahim Mohamed Soli on the 23rd of September when the elections were held and when just the informal results were out. They were not formally declared. And he was the first one to call him, to congratulate him. And even at that time, Soli had mentioned that he would like very much the Prime Minister to come and participate and attend his inauguration on the 17th of November. And if you recall, Maldives is the only country that the Prime Minister has not visited out of all the 8 SAARC member states. He was actually scheduled to go there in March 2015 when he had toured Sri Lanka, Seychelles, etc., etc. But then at the last minute, the visit was cancelled because there were so many of the anti-government protests and demonstrations that were going on the streets. So it was thought prudent not to go to Malé at that time. So here, of course, its importance is importance of Maldives as far as India's foreign relations and strategic and security concerns are concerned. It is quite obvious. It's one of the neighbors. And we see that we have always had good relations, but since 2012, when Mohamed Nasheed was ousted by force, he has gone on record to say that it was a coup he was subjected to. So ever since then, our relations with Maldives have been on a downhill direction. China has been gaining ground at the expense of India. And Abdullah Yameen, who came to power, who won, so to say, and I'll put, you know, a big question mark against one, the presidential elections in 2013, because they were very, very controversial. In the first round, Mohamed Nasheed had won, and then after that, he took the matter to the Election Commission and to the Supreme Court, and then as a result of whatever fiddle they might have done, he won the second round of, that was nullified, and then he won the elections. And so since then, the relations with India have been coming down. China, and in recent past, we have seen that Maldives has signed on to the Belt and Road Initiative, which brings China right onto the doorstep of India, and particularly with the sort of presence that it has already been able to ensure in Sri Lanka. So this would be another headache for India. So Abdullah Yameen had signed on to the Belt Road Initiative. He had changed the constitution of the country to lease out a number of prime islands to China. Then in late last year, he sort of pushed through a free trade agreement between Maldives and China. That more than 1,000-page document, he barely gave half an hour to his parliamentarians to sort of, you know, go through and approve. So it was a sham that it was approved. And he also provided an observation post to China in one of the islands which is very, very close to India. So for all these reasons and more, India was getting concerned. Also, it has been turning into a hotbed for Islamic fundamentalism.
The fact that Abdullah Yameen made this very clear preference known for Beijing as opposed to New Delhi, and went out of his way, as it were, to almost mock New Delhi and her overtures, despite the fact that when there was a water crisis, it was India which got water tankers and ships across. Do you now see Soli's swearing in today and the subsequent presidency that he's going to have as something that maybe gives India a chance to come back into the reckoning in the Maldives? I mean, clearly China is concerned because they have not only tried their hardest to back Yameen to, you know, put up a challenge to the results in the Supreme Court and various other things, They've also moved over to Sri Lanka and created a mess there. So do you think Soli's election is going to help India regain a lot of the lost ground in the Maldives?
Yes. To respond to your question briefly, yes, I think it opens up a large number of possibilities. It opens up a large number of opportunities. We will have to play our cards very well. You are very right that China was extremely guarded on the 23rd of September when the elections took place. In addition to India, a large number of other democracies around the world, whether it is USA, even the Secretary General of the United Nations, Canada, European Union, Australia, all of them came out and very warmly welcomed this result, more so because it was not expected, because Abdullah Yameen had used all the tricks of the trade in terms of locking up his adversaries and putting his adversaries on exile and not allowing Mohammad Nasheed to contest the elections as a presidential candidate and so on and so forth. So he'd done everything that he could have done. So it must have come as a very rude shock for him that he lost the elections so convincingly. He just got 41% of the vote as against Ibrahim Mohammed Saleh's 58%. So, you know, that is what really would have put him in shock, and that is why to begin with, he seemed to accept the result. It was only later on when his confabulations with his cohorts, he would have decided to challenge it and to go to the Supreme Court. But coming back to China, China was extremely guarded in its response, and it said that they hoped that the new government, whichever it would come, would behave in a responsible manner and would give protection to Chinese investments. So let us definitely say that it is not that China will be thrown out of the reckoning, not at all. This is what Mohammad Nasheed has been saying. Ibrahim Mohammed Saleh has also been saying that we are going to investigate, we are going to open up all the contracts that have been given because they have all been done in a non-democratic manner, in a non-transparent manner, and there's a lot of corruption involved, they're not commercially viable and all that sort of things. But be that as it may, you know, China has invested so much of money, so it is the sovereign government that is beholden to China. 70% of the Maldivian debt is owed to China. So in that sense, China will be there and will continue to be an important player. But the manner in which India had been completely sidelined, that I think we have the possibility to change that situation. And we have played our cards extremely well so far, starting from 1st February 2018 when this whole crisis erupted. And till now, in terms of putting out demarches and notwarbals being issued to the Maldivian government that they should respect whatever the Supreme Court has said and so on and so forth. So I think we will need to play our cards well, but it definitely gives us an opportunity. We've put our foot in the door and slowly and gradually, without sort of, you know, violently jerking it up, slowly and gradually we have the possibility to open up. And I think this is very, very evident from what the two tweets that the Prime Minister has issued this morning, when he has said that India is fully prepared and ready to cooperate and collaborate with the Maldivian government. Just one this thing, in what areas? In areas of infrastructure development, because that is the area where China has been there. Education, healthcare, and human resource development. So all these are very, very critical areas.
Apparently, the debt at this point that the Maldivian government owes is in the region of $1.5 billion, which is, as you said, about 70% of their GDP. It's all very well to say that India has put a foot in, but can India reach deep down into its pockets to actually try and help them replace that debt so that the government doesn't sink under a debt crisis as, say, countries like Sri Lanka are beginning to feel? So is it a possibility that India step in where China might be stepping out?
I think there would be possibilities for India to step in. And I think India will be stepping in not alone, but India will be stepping in along with Japan, India will be stepping in along with the United States, and along with the European Union. Because I think all these countries are also concerned, maybe not equally concerned. For India, the concern is much greater because it's right on our doorstep. And, you know, when we have been talking about the string of pearls, then this would be another pearl that China had added onto the string. So we will be going in there, And then we will make sure that the terms and conditions on which these infrastructure development projects are offered, that those don't result in a debt trap. I think as far as Sri Lanka is concerned, it was the first time that such this proposition was made in Hambantota, and that is why it might have taken them by surprise. But now I think the whole world is aware of this, and even we have seen question marks being raised, whether it is in Malaysia, even in Nepal, even in Pakistan, on the China-Pakistan Economic Corridor project. So I think here also, whatever China has invested, that of course Maldives would be required to pay back in whatever terms, conditions it is there. But I think going forward, there would be so much more possibility of getting funding and support for infrastructure development from India and from the other countries who are equally keen that this government, you know, should succeed because it is following the autocratic regime of Abdullah Yameen.
Do you think at this point there would be a salutary lesson for Ibrahim Soli and the Maldivian Democratic Party, people like Nasheed and even now the former President Abdul Gayoom, that they should sort of come together to ensure that there isn't a kind of a repetition of what exactly has happened now in Sri Lanka, where the strong man who was perceived as being this pro-China person, as in Rajapaksa, was suddenly appointed one night and the democratically elected Vikramasinghe was thrown out. Now, is there a fear, unless the Maldives, the government now, unites behind all of the polls, because you have Soli as kind of a figurehead, he was a common candidate, but you also have a very powerful Nasheed, you have the former president, Mr. Gayoom. Unless these people get together, is there a chance that China comes in again and tries to do the kind of thing that it's done to destabilize in the Maldives now?
I think they'll have to be wary of that. As you know, that this is Soli is a consensus candidate for parties. So he had been put up by all the opposition coming together. So far, how to run the coalition and how to make sure that there are no fissures that are developed within this coalition, I think that will be a challenge for Soli. I think since both Mohammad Nasheed and Ibrahim Mohammed Soli, they come from the same party, Maldivian Democratic Party. So it might be easier to ensure that they are on the same page, they are on the same wavelength, and they are able to continue. But in that, what I can foresee is that Nasheed will have to make sure that his personal ambitions, because after all, he was the president from 2008 till 2012, till he was ousted. And Soli is really, in that sense, the proxy candidate standing in for Mohammad Nasheed. Because otherwise, if Nasheed had not been made ineligible to contest, he definitely would have been the candidate and he definitely would have romped home to victory against Abdullah Yameen, as Soli has done. I'm sure he will occupy an important position. We have seen the images of both these leaders passing through the streets of Male, and they have been there have been lots of supporters and they have been responding to them. So I think the challenge will be there for them to stay united, to stay together. As far as Gayoom is concerned, I think his significance and importance in that sense is more symbolic, because you know he was seen to have been dictatorial presence from 1978 to 2008. 30 years he ruled the place. And of late, although Abdullah Yameen is his close relative, he had moved to the opposition. Yeah. So I think they will have to keep him also on the right side. Otherwise, Abdullah Yameen and Gayoom could also make common cause against
them. It's unlikely, given the fact that Yameen actually bunked him in jail. I don't think at this age Gayoom is going to take too kindly to that.
He is advanced in years and Gayoom doesn't have to do anything much. But if he's sidelined totally, then certain circumstances could arise. But I take your point that it appears unlikely.
Thanks very much, Ambassador.
Thank you.
You were listening to a discussion on significance of Prime Minister's visit to Maldives. The participants were Ashok Sajjanhar, former diplomat, and Nilova Rai Chaudhary, journalist. This program was produced and presented by the News Services Division of All India Radio. This program is also available on our website newsonair.nic.in.